thought that Hank would... He would find someone before I did. You know, if I ever did.
Guess I just sort of messed up your plans.
Well, as a matter of fact, you did.
The three major food groups of cool. Miles, Monk, and Mingus.
What about Beethoven, Brahms, and Bach?
Mr. Hank and I got divorced. I just didn't know who I was anymore without him, you know?
I know.
And it just took leading a very solitary life for a very, very long time for me to figure out who I was and what I did and why I did it. I just figured that's the way it was going to be for the rest of my life. Me and my work, interspersed with a few bursts of sunshine from Rachel.
You didn't think that you would ever get married again?
Married again? I hardly dated. I mean, except for one miserable affair with one of the partners in the Chicago law firm. I lived the life of a hermit.
This affair, it didn't work out?
Oh, it was wonderful.
Get?
No. I didn't know how to do both. I didn't know how to be me and be in a relationship. And now something always got eclipsed, either me or the work or the relationship, but mostly me.
You seem pretty well balanced now.
Thank you.
I love it when you get so absorbed in a case that when I talk to you, you just sort of make these little listening noises and everything. But I know the whole time you're just playing in that case.
You cannot possibly love that. That is rude and insulting.
No.
Yes, it is.
No. Listen to me. What that means is that on the most basic level, you know that you can just drift away, you know, with work. And then when you get back, I want to be right there. See?
I think this is why I was so scared to talk about marriage. I was scared that all this happiness that I'm feeling, and that's a pretty alien feeling, you know, in itself. I was afraid that all this happiness would just go away. That someone upstairs would look in their little book and they would see, oh, Nora Gannon, whoa, she is way over her quota of happiness. And they just pull the plug.
Oh, God. Well, you got some pretty weird ideas how they pass time up there in heaven, eh? You got to relax. Listen, we are together because we're supposed to be together. We were made to be. And we'll be together for a long, long time.
Rookie's been benched for dribbling out of bounds.
But wait, there's a substitution. Huggies Ultra Trim Diapers with new stretch.
General Hospital, only on ABC Daytime.
We would have looked at this house on a cold February night. We'd have never bought it.
You love
the floor is like an ice rink.
Oh, you love this house.
I love this house, but I love being warm.
It's a good thing we're getting married in June then, don't you think?
Yeah.
We're still on for June 1st, right?
That's right. June 1st. Oh, what kind of ceremony you want?
Honey.
I'm thinking.
Oh, brother.
What?
Well, if it takes you that long to think, it means you have absolutely no idea what kind of ceremony.
Oh, well, now that's entirely not wrong. I just... Oh, I don't know. There's a part of me that just wants Paul McGilly, you know, the rabbi in the synagogue and getting married under the chuppah with his hand sewn by my mother. It would make my family so happy.
Mm.
But somehow I can't imagine seeing the Buke sitting there with yarmulkes on the head. No, any more than I can imagine my family sitting happily in the pew with smiling through a Protestant ceremony.
Yeah. I do like the part where they stomp on the glass, though.
Oh, I love that. It was my favorite part of the whole Jewish service. And you know what? It was all because of this, that Hank and I ended up in an institutionalized green room being married by a bored, very boring justice of the peace.
Real traditional, huh?
Traditional. My cousin Nancy, who was our witness, was so bummed that I wasn't wearing a white dress that she came dressed in white.
You're kidding.
Mm-hmm.
So we don't want a traditional religious service.
No.
All right. We don't want some dusty old civil ceremony.
Definitely not. So what are we going to do? In some tacky chapel by an Elvis impersonator like Tina and David.
Thank you very much.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Well, what are our alternatives in Las Vegas?
Forget the wedding. Let's just go there and be lounge acts. We can be the Bobarellas.
How about the Norrells?
Ooh, I got it. Bo and the Blue Cannons.
That's it.
That's what?
Rock and roll.
Rock and roll.
We have to have a rock and roll wedding.
We do?
Yes.
Who's going to officiate a rock and roll wedding?
Little Richard. Rock and roll's his religion. He is the high priest of rock and roll. Somebody say, amen.
Amen.
Ernie Keebler, ma'am.
The Elf?
Yes, ma'am.
I don't...
Discretion advised.
Wait, one thing. Just a second. The thing with the glass.
Yeah, from the Jewish ceremony.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
We could keep that in, right?
Yeah, it's fine with me if it's fine with Little Richard.
What's not to like?
We'll discuss it all with Little Richard, yeah? We've got until June to figure out all the details, including finding Little Richard. Let's just get through one wedding at a time.
Funny.
Mm-hmm.
You feel strange going to Hank's wedding, don't you?
No. If it's his first wedding, why shouldn't it be this one? My daughter's father's getting me married. I just hope I'm the only unlikely family member there.
RJ.
I don't want him wrecking things for Hank and Sheila. You know, he's already put him through enough.
I wasn't going to tell you this. He crashed Hank's bachelor party.
Oh, you're kidding. Hank must have gone through the roof.
Okay, really. I mean, he's pretty cool under the circumstances.
Wish there was some way to keep him from crashing Hank's and Sheila's wedding. What?
I'm about to be brilliant twice in one night. What are the odds?
Well, where are you going?
Out.
Out? As long as you promise to come back and be brilliant maybe three times in a night?
No, what do you mean? The old hat trick? Could be.
Who said you could wear a hat?
There's just going to be so many people in the house. If they weren't twins, I mean, I'm glad they are twins. I think it's...
Uh-huh.
dreams may turn to dust, but I don't think you